Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. And today I thought of doing a voiceover. I'm not really sure if I will be able to do the complete video with my live voice over, but I thought let me give it a try. So I have picked up this tray, this MDF tray, and I thought of doing decoupage on this with some basic stamping. And so I'm not sure, actually this has been lying with me since long, and I think it's high time that I accompany my last tray with a new one. So let's get started. So I have this beautiful decoupage tissue paper from Zero Brands, and I got this paper sometime back, and I really love these flowers. So if you remember, my earlier video on MDF tray had some nice Indian touch decoupage papers, and I thought of doing this in a little contrast one, and I picked up this paper. So this is very nice floral designs on all the four sides, and as you can see, my tray is really small, so I think I can use this portion maybe. Yeah, I will have to cut this flower a bit, maybe somewhere from here. So I'll be using this. So first let me cut this paper, and for this I am going to use my water, my paintbrush, and I'm going to divide it into two parts. So it's a very easy technique. Just dip your brush, give a border to your pattern from where you want to have a cut, and it's done. You just need to be a little careful, cause these are tissues. These are really thin. Yes, it comes with one ply, two ply, the different plies you get, but still you need to be really careful with this, cause if you overdo with water, there are chances that you can tear off your designs, and we don't want it, right? I'm really sorry for coughing, cause I have a really bad throat now, and it's actually a little chill in Bangalore, and the weather is not really good actually. So we all have been really busy with our traveling, then this cold cough, so a little tough time for us, but it's good to be back to crafting after such a long time, cause I was traveling to one of the different states here, and I was actually traveling for one of my cousin's marriage, and it was a 4-day like super awesome trip with so much of fun and giggles and everything. So I thought let me give me some rest and then start crafting. So finally today is the day. So I think let me just check this with my tray once again, and I think so actually the size of this tray is approximately 6 by 6 sorry, and inside it is going to come like this. So maybe what I can do is I can trim off this side, because I don't want this plain straight lines on my edges, and maybe I can cut off this leaves portion, and cut off this side. So you can see I am just trimming off from the borders. I'm leaving very less white portions, and I'm going to make sure that it doesn't look like a very straight line. The best part of using tissue papers is that you can really blend in with any color. I've even done a tutorial where I actually used no color, and I did it on a fox leather, and that project actually turned out to be really good, and I was really happy. A big pat on my back. And yeah, so that's the fun part of doing decoupage actually. Can really blend in the colors, do something different, come up with something really creative, and experiment. Like I always say, please experiment with your supplies, and you can actually learn so many things which you will not learn in any of your classes. Or the practical learning is always good. So here now I'm happy with my trimming. This looks good, and I think I can just fold it on the sides a bit and then I can stick it. So this looks good. Now I need to remove my ply, and for this you need to be really careful, because can you see it's so thin? You actually don't even realize that it has two layers, but yes, it has. Some of the tissues, they come with two plies, like the first layer of your design, then two sheets beneath that. So that is a little more tricky to remove, but once you try, so then you can easily do it. And I'm finding it very difficult to remove my ply. Maybe I should start from this corner. Yeah. So it is a little tricky. Yeah, okay. So this one also has three ply. So I'm going to remove this one. This is the first ply. Can you see the nice design on this, the embossing effect? Now it's time to remove the second ply, and it's really thin. You need to be really careful. I love this design and I don't want to ruin it. Yeah, so finally I'm able to do it. Yes. Ah, and I did it. So see, these are the two plies, and this is my final sheet. And I got some queries that why you need to add colors to your base. It depends on the kind of base you're working on, because like in this, if I add any other background color, it is really going to smudge very well, because this layer is very thin, and it is going to be semi-transparent, and you can actually see the base color. So you can even play around with the colors. You can have 2-3 colors in this. So I have decided to use my yellow shade and my acrylic green shade, and I'm going to blend in these two colors, and then I'm going to stick my this. So now we'll switch on to the sticking, my coloring part, sorry. And for that I will need my sponge dauber. This is the second size of sponge dauber which I use for almost all my projects, and I love this size because this is actually good for my standard size products. So now it's time to start coloring. Now for this I am very sure that I am going to lay this paper like this. Like I'm going to leave the handles on the side, and it will be something like this. So now I'm going to color this up completely. Maybe I can add some more tissues on the sides. I'm not sure. Yeah, maybe I can add some tissues on the sides. So let me cut this. Okay. So I am thinking of using this pattern on one side. Maybe I'll take this one. Okay. So, and I'm going to cut all the four sides from here. Okay. I think I need to mark it with a pencil so that my work becomes easy and I can save some time. So like I said, you don't need to be perfect for this. This is for one bottle, this is for second bottle, this is for third bottle, and this is for the fourth side. Okay, this looks good, and
Let me complete this line. Okay. Okay, so my two layers are done, and first I'm going to peel it off so that I can just cut it and stick it. And yay, I can see my first layer coming out. Yeah, so this is my first layer. You need to be really delicate with these so that you can remove it easily. This is my first layer. And now I'm going to remove the second layer. And I can see my second layer. So there are many options of doing this tray. Like, I could have done just the plain coloring and then the decoupage tissue on the center, just to make the center point highlight. But it's a tray, and I am going to definitely keep something inside these trays. Like, I use my trays for small teeny mini jars and for serving some small snacks. So the center portion is going to be filled up with some of the other things. So I thought, let me color the borders, add some tissues to the border also, which might make it look a little more beautiful. This is really tricky, but I love it. Oh, so I'm done with removing this. Now I had marked my lines on this one, so I'm going to keep it here like this, or like this, and then I'm going to cut okay. I'm sorry. Yeah, so now I'm done with this. Now it's time to cut my paper, and you can see my pencil line, so I just need to cut the straight line. You really don't have to worry about cutting these, even if it's a little uneven, it's okay, because we are going to use our color at the base, so it is going to get smudged, so no worries about that. And I am going to show you some tips at the end, so please stay tuned, because decoupage is fun and you need to learn so many tips and tricks to cover your projects, to finish your projects, to give it a new look, and to try so many things. So I'm done with my cutting work. I'll just remove the extra papers to and three and and four. Yeah, so my four tissues are done. My center tissue is already with me. I'll keep them aside and we'll start coloring. So like I said, I want to use two different colors in this, the green and the yellow. And I'll zoom in the camera so that you can see the coloring, how I'm going to blend the colors. It's super easy. Take your colors with a blending brush. It's super easy and super fast, and you know which area we have to color. So it's the borders, this, the inner borders, and some of the base area. So I am going to have my flower something like this. So the major portion where I have to color is this one. Okay, now I'll start adding colors, and you can see how easy it is. I'm just thinking maybe I'll cover the entire inner portion of my tray, so that my even the base beneath the decoupage paper has some shades, and looks, I think it will look going, it is going to look good. So yeah, The best part of using your blending foam is that you can actually cover up all these corners really well. So you just need to dab it like this, and you can always twist and turn your sponge, and it works wonderful. I'm not really sure if my voice is really clear. Yes, I'm recording it, but I am not at all sure. I can know it only once I'm done with it, because I really don't want to stop now. And Bane is sleeping. It's her sleeping time. She has already slept, and I don't want her to wake up, and I don't want to stop this video in the mid. So I am going to do this video fast. So you can see how nicely my color is blending. You can see this is coming out really good. And now I'm going to add my yellow shade. Okay, now this is dried a little, but no worries. I have my sponge dauber, and that's the best part of your sponge dauber, that you can blend in the colors really well. Okay, like I said, it's in a floral theme, so I thought of using more of yellow green, and maybe I'm loving this green color a lot. I love green color, I love blue color, so maybe I will use green a little more. Okay, and in the other corner I will have this yellow. So if you feel that your sponge has so much of color if you feel that your sponge has so much of color and you really want to use it, then dab it on the plain surface area so that you can have all the colors around. And here you can see the color blending. There's no particular way that you have to do it in this way only or that way only. The color should be like this, the shading has to be like this. No, there is no specific thing. It's completely up to you that how you want your end product to be look. But yes, there are a few things which you need to keep in mind while doing decoupage. Is one is like making sure that your layers are sticked properly. You need to make sure that your Mod Podge, the sealer, they dry out completely. And I've also seen people using Mod Podge in a very, very small quantity, and which is not good, because that is something which is actually going to bind your paper, like keep your paper sticked to your project, the base. So it's really important to have a very good sealer and a very good Mod Podge, and make sure you apply ample amount of the Mod Podge. So I am almost done with the inner sides. I'm just going to rub my brush because I want to give it a very fade look. I don't want it to look like a complete black thing. It is something which is with the floral design, I love a bit of rustic look. I don't want it to look always the very straight and the perfect thing, because that's how nature is. It's not the perfect thing, right? I love the shady things. I love the imperfection in nature, and that's what our life is about. So same way, I feel our project should not be always the perfect thing. I do lots of mixed media projects, and I enjoy doing that. Like, I even did some projects where I altered a bouquet stand. It was a floral bouquet stand which I used, and I altered it, and it was imperfect. I was told that, oh, this is not going to look good, but now I use it as a tea light holder and it looks fab. Hmm. now on the corners, I just need to dab my sponge dauber and spread my color. And my borders are done. I'm just dabbing it to make sure that it dries out and it spreads evenly, and this looks good now. Now I'll just cover up the edges because I am going to use my tissue paper and it's not really even, so I need to cover up the edges, and that's how it will look more natural and more good. I was asked that why I use sponge dauber more, cause this is something which is really easy to blend, and this is that my convenience level with the sponge dauber is a little more and I love using it. Yes, it absorbs colors a little more, so at times I feel bad, but when I see the end product, it's totally worth it. So you can see how I'm shading the edges, just the borders, very less, and I'm done with my third side. Oh, I left some empty spaces here which I need to cover. Maybe I can brush it up with my paintbrush. Yeah, and now I can just blend it with my sponge dauber. And now it's time to cover up the fourth space and the border actually, and it's almost done. I'm going to use my heat gun to speed up the drying process, and I will be back once I'm done with my drying this tray. And this looks good and I'm very happy. So I'll come back once I am done with this drying process and cleaning my hands. So here I'm done with my drying of my paints, and this looks good, but I need to add my decoupage tissues here. So we will start with the center portion, and for that I need to have a brush, my Mod Podge matte finish and my tissues, and let's get started. So I'm going to apply a generous coat of Mod Podge, and like I said, I'm going to place it like this. So I need to cover up the complete base, and I need to cover up the upper portion also, get this, because my paper is going to actually come up on the sides. Maybe I should zoom in a little more so that when I stick, you guys can see the detailing. Speed up my process. So when you have to stick your sides, just make sure that you cover up these edges so that one go you can stick your paper, and then you can stick the sides by adding some extra adhesive. So sticking the sides, the corner, the edges is a little tricky part, because there are the high chances that you will miss out on adding adhesive there. Yeah, so maybe I should add something here and here, and this looks good. And now it's time to stick my paper. And yeah, you need to be really, really careful with this, because obviously we don't want any wrinkles or air bubbles or anything. And now with my paintbrush, I'm just going to dab it on the corners. So you can see the extra portion has come out, and likewise, just stick it. And now you need to press it really, really gently, so that you don't have any of the bubbles or air gaps. And you can see the whole embossing thing on the paper is gone. Now you can stick on this paper on the top nicely and it's done. Now we'll stick the other side as well and we'll use the same technique. So now you can see actually there are no bubbles and you just need to press it a little lighter so that there is no bubbles, and you can see the edges, it is just coming up and you can't even make out that I have sticked one paper. It's looking like a print and the whole embossing thing of this tissue paper is gone. Now it's time to stick the outer sides and then we'll move on to the remaining portion. Maybe I need to cut this a little more. So I'm done with the cutting work and it's time to stick these, and without wasting any time I'll do my sticking work. And off camera I had to cut the borders cause it was very uneven and a little bigger in size and I wanted it to look a little smaller so that I can see my green color paper, the decoupage tissues. So that I can see my green color acrylic paint from the sides. So I had to cut it. Now I will be sticking these. I'm not going to follow any pattern. I am just going to stick it randomly. And I just need to make sure that it's a little straight. Not completely, but yes, straight. Now I am going to spread this with my brush so that there are no wrinkles and sticks properly on my base. And you can see I could do it without any wrinkle and this looks good. Don't worry about this uneven spaces because later on also I am going to do some coloring and some technique on these, and I will make sure that it does not look uneven. So now you must be wondering what to do with this handle part. Don't worry, we are just going to apply this on this side and then I am going to cut the remaining portion from the center. Now I'm done with this sticking. Yeah, just press it gently and you can see how the perforation vanishes, and I am almost done with this part. Now for the center portion, I am going to just trim it off a little. Now here with my spatula, I'm just going to cut it and then I'm going to fold it inside and stick it. Now before sticking that, I am going to make sure that I apply my adhesive really good way so that get stick poly, because this is something which is really tricky. I cannot put my brush completely on these edges, so I need to be a little careful extra careful for this. So earlier I was not a big fan of decoupage. I honestly didn't took so much of interest in this artwork. I thought this was not my cup of tea, and I actually gave away so many of my supplies to my friends and fellow crafters. And later on, when I started doing this, it's an addiction. Trust me, it's an addiction. I am sharing a pic. See this stool. So it was a plain wooden stool which was with me for almost 3 years or 4 years now. And after shifting to Bangalore, one day me and Vanya, we thought of doing some experiment, and we ended up doing decoupage on this particular stool, and it turned out to be so good. And that's how we started doing decoupage. Now even Vanya also loves doing decoupage projects. She has done a couple of videos on decoupage box, decoupage gift box, then decoupage MDF hangers. And yeah, she has been behind me for some more projects, but honestly, she's already tied up with so many things. She plays tennis, she plays chess. Her school timing is like from morning to evening. And then that poor girl, she hardly gets any time to play with her friends, but still she wants to do videos, which I have been telling her not to, because she's a poor little girl, just 6 years old and going to be 7 now, but still she's too small for so many things. But the good part is she loves doing these things, and she knows how to manage her time, and which is really commendable. So I really appreciate her for her time management. But yeah, she's very fussy. She wants her supplies to be perfect. She wants everything I have, and at times we have some small fights for craft supplies. And we fight a lot. And when we sit to decide on the artwork, there's always like she wants to do something else, I have planned for something else, and then we end up making something else. So it's a very tedious process to convince her. If she has decided on something, then whatever it is, she is not going to change her mind. And you really can't convince her with any of the chit chats and everything. You have to give her a rock solid reason, then only she is going to get convinced. So you can imagine how tough it is. So I'm done with my Mod Podge, and now now my tissue paper, and this looks quite good. So you can see there was some bubble here. Just use your brush and you can easily remove it. And you need to be really gentle when you are doing this, because these are really, really thin tissue papers. The decoupage tissue papers are really thin. If you are a beginner, you can always start with the decoupage papers. So I'm associated with Zero Brands, and they have some really amazing designs of decoupage papers. If you are a follower of my YouTube channel, you must have seen that I've done so many videos with their decoupage tissues. And I've even done a video with some nice background with decoupage papers, and it was really fun. So experiment, friends, experiment a lot. Experiment as much as you can. Yes, you get some products for some particular thing, but You can always experiment, and you never know what really comes into your interest level and what excites you more the next time. Like I said, I was not a big fan of decoupage. I was not really sure if it is going to be my cup of tea, because I was so engrossed with my scrapbooking and my mixed media projects that I used to hardly get time, and now I actually do lots of decoupage projects. So it is going to be fun if you start doing it. Now I'm done with this, and I'm just going to stick my papers on the inner side. It already has so much of Mod Podge, and you can also remove the extra paper if you want. So here I'm done with the sticking work, and this looks good now. So if you are just using this as a decorative piece, you can always have it like this. And if you want to use for your daily utility or something, you can use it. Now I'll let it dry completely and then we'll be back. So here my tray has dried out completely and it looks fab. You can see the edges, and I need to blend some color now. So here I am going to use my, I've decided to use my yellow color. I got a new pack of acrylic yellow color, and yes, it's the next day. I had to do some my household work, and then I had to sleep, and now I got some time. I went to market, I got the colors, and now I am going to use it. But I just realized that my sponge is a little wet, but no worries, I'm just going to blend in the color so you can see how beautiful it looks. And I'm just going to dab a little lightly so that I do not smudge my complete color. So make sure, keep this in mind, that your colors should blend really well, and for that you need to have a nice dry base. And I'm just going to extend it to my sides so that it looks like one piece. And for this you need to add a little pressure. I'm again sorry for my bad throat. I'm actually having very bad cold and cough, and because of that I have been struggling with my voiceovers. I did record few of my voice records for my another videos which I had done long back, but it's in vain because of this good cold in Bangalore, you really can't help it. So yeah, and now again I'm going to add some green color here. So here is my green color, and I'm going to add the same on my sponge, just a small quantity, and then I'm going to smudge it. So you can see now this actually blends well. Can you see? Yeah. And I'm just going to dab some on the center portion, on the sides, and just dab, and then you can see your colors blending really well. So if you blend your color on the center of your paper somewhere, It actually gives a very natural look. This is my personal favorite thing to do. And see, you can see on the sides, earlier it was looking like a plain line and now it has some nice shading on it. You can always change the consistency of your color. You can always just make sure that it blends well. And I'm quite happy with this now. First, I'm going to cover up my sides completely on the borders, and then I'm going to give this touch up here. And it's done. I might do some shading on the edges to give it a nice green yellow shade. Like I said, you don't have to be just perfect. You can just blend in some color. And see now how beautiful it looks, right? You can see some of the gap because of my small paper. So I can just blend in some more color. This is actually just going to highlight your paper. It is going to make it a little popping design. And can you see the difference on this side and this side? This looks very plain, and now with the color blending, this looks so cool. So this is how you can blend in the colors. Now again, I'm going to take some yellow and some green, or more of green and less of yellow, and I'm going to blend in on the edges. If you feel that you have put up a lot more color, you can always just dab it a little more and you can remove the extra color, and it's done. I did not try my shimmer paints on this, but you can surely check the shimmer paints coloring option also, because even that also looks really good. And especially with any of your traditional designs, they add some extra charm to it. And I have done a couple of videos. You can check my decoupage playlist in my on my channel, and it has some really nice designs with shimmer paints and shimmer sprays which I've used while doing decoupage work. I think I need to add a little more of green and yellow color here, so you can see how much I'm taking, just a drop of color, and I'm going to blend it. First I'm going to spread my color, and then I'm going to blend it really well. And I'm just going to make sure that my decoupage tissues look nice and popped out. And I'm done. Yes, I am done. Now for highlighting the handles, I have just dabbed my sponge only once. Here I'm going to repeat the same. The best part of using these acrylic paints or the shimmer paints is that it dries out really fast too. So you don't have to spend so much of time in the drying process, and this actually gives you ample of time to switch to your next shade and you can blend in your colors. I might need to add some more shades here. So I will So my color blending work is done, and now let me clean up my brush, let me use my heat gun to speed up the drying process, and then I'll be back. So I'm done with the drying process of my tray, and this looks fab now, and I'm really happy with the final outcome, and I have decided to use my stamping on this. Now I have two stamps here. One is from Crafty Scrappers. They have this really nice butterfly and sentiment background stamp, which I'm going to use on my project, and then I have my scripted stamp. Let's see how it goes. I have not decided anything, but I actually loved this pattern and I think this will really go well with my project, and maybe I can add these butterflies on my borders also. So, and for that I am going to use my Kavel permanent ink pad, and let's start stamping. Now I am not going to use my acrylic base for this, and I'm going to make sure that I stamp my butterflies nicely, and I want to make sure that my sentiment and everything goes well, and I don't want a perfect stamping. I'm using my sponge dauber cause my ink pad is drying, and this looks nice. Yeah, maybe I'll add this patch or the sentiment here and some sentiments here, and for that I will use this one because it will make my work a little more easier. So here it goes, and you really can't find much of difference in the text, so it works well for me. Now again I'm going to have some more ink. I think I should use the bottom part so that it's easy for me to stamp, and again I'm going to use my sponge dauber, and I'm done. So how is it looking? Yeah, let me add some more stamping here, and then I am going to stamp this, particularly this butterfly, on one corner. So for this I am going to use this, press it with my fingers, and you see how pretty it looks. I'm going to repeat the same for all the corners. I'm going to have my butterfly on one corner. Yeah, and this side too. Generally you don't need to press your ink pads and stamp so hard, but my pad is drying and I need to buy a new one, so I need to put some extra effort. And now I'm going to use this script stamp on the other sides for just my patch stamping, and you can see how lovely it looks. Maybe I'll add some more stamping on the borders. Yeah, this looks good. Now I'll repeat the process on the other side, and you don't have to be very very particular because this is actually going to be just the shading part, and this is just going to complement your artwork. So you really don't have to worry that it should be a perfect thing, and that's the reason I'm not using my acrylic block for this one. So yeah, I'll just add some patch of stencil, and now I am going to use my stamp on this corners, so just to make sure that it looks complete. And I'm going to just turn my tray, add some stamping, again turn my tray, add some stamping. Now for the inner space there are two options: either you can use it like this only, the empty, or you can add some stamp. So I'm going to follow the pattern of my text, so for this I'm going to keep it like this, take my stamp, I'm just going to do the patch stamping, and this looks complete. Now for this one I am going to use this portion of my stamp so that the sentiment looks in a continuous way. So here I'm going to just stamp on this side, and I'm going to stamp it. Yeah, and can you see it's looking like this? Sentiment is going in a line. Now for this side I'm going to use this border of my, the side of my stamp. And you need very little ink for this one because it's on the size, it has handles, and you don't need to do much on this side. Yeah. So, and now for this one, I'm going to use this part. And I'm done with my stamping, and it's time to use my Mod Podge. And again, I'm going to use the matte finish. And once I'm done with the Mod Podge, then I'm going to use my wood varnish. Now, for applying my Mod Podge, the same technique, you just need a thin and even layer of your Mod Podge, and you need to make sure that you apply it completely on your base. I can have some more of Mod Podge here. Make sure you don't have any grids here so that it's easy for you to blend and it becomes smoother. Otherwise you will have those very very fine lines because of the brush. So I need to speed up a little more, and immediately I am going to cover up the sides also fast. When I bought my first jar of Mod Podge, I thought, oh, I will be using this so much and it's actually going to finish up very fast. But no, that's not the case with Mod Podge. One jar is so sufficient for your so many projects. And with Nagashri Arts, you have so many jars where you get different size, and you can actually use or buy any of the sizes. And it's super easy. Just make sure that you close your bottle really tight after each use so that it doesn't dry out, the product doesn't dry out, and you can use it again. Now here you can see I have some extra Mod Podge. I'll just remove it with my brush, and now I'm going to cover up the sides. I love using Mod Podge and I love doing decoupage, so this is I think one of my third tray or the fourth tray. No, actually I did one MDF tray, I also revamped one of my old plastic tray, which was one of my first tray which I bought after my wedding, and I did not want to throw it. It was a very small and old one, so with a new look it has got some more value now, and now I use it in my kitchen. So yes, the best part of decoupage is you can always revamp it, and if you can do some mixed media on it, nothing like it. It is going to make your project look fab, and it's always so nostalgic to use your pieces for your utility. I will speed on the music a little louder. You can enjoy this Mod Podge session, and I'll be back once I'm done with this and my Mod Podge has dried out. And it's time to do the final touch of work, and here my tray is ready. It has dried out completely. The mud podge has dried out completely and it looks fab. But yes, we need to add cilia to it. It is very, very important to add your varnish, the cilia, to your project, so that when you use it for a longer time, it stays as it is and you can always clean it. The cleaning becomes really easy. So here I'm going to use my wood varnish and it's a water based. I had some varnish in this. I added some water and now this is perfect to seal my project. I am going to share the links below in the description box. You can check that and make sure you use your cilia in your decoupage project. Now it depends, if you are going to use that project for some very roughened up use, I always prefer having two coats of cilia. And if it's just a simple decorative piece like any MDF magnet or anything, the one cilia is sufficient because you are going to clean it once a while. You are not going to have any rough handling work with that object. So it depends. It completely depends on the kind of utility you have with that project. So in this, for sure, I am going to have my two coats of cilia. I have tried almost all the varieties of cilia and this is something which I really love and I highly recommend to use on your wooden or your MDF projects, because this actually works very, very well and you can use your project for a longer time. And I have been using my I have been using my trays and my artwork for almost years now and they are still as it is. So that's the best part of using your cilia. For my decorative projects, any of my MDA decorative projects, I have even used that acrylic spray varnish and it worked well. I have actually used it for my mixed media projects. So you can check in my playlist. There are so many videos with mixed media tutorial and at the end I have added some sprays and it works wonder. So here I am done. This process is really fast and you need to make sure that once you're done with this, you let it dry completely and then start with your next layer so that your base absorbs this properly and you get ample of time for drying and then you can use it. I think I didn't, this side is also done. So my inner side is done and I need to cover up the sides. So first I'm going to finish up the sides and then I am going to use the other, then actually I'm going to color use my sealer on the other sides, and I'm going to make sure that I use my sealer on every inch. Adding sealer also adds some extra shine to your project. I have not seen any matte finish sealer, but with these wood varnish you always get some kind of shine, which I personally like having it on my project. So yes, so once I'm done with this, I am going to definitely use my sealer on the backside, because that is the important part of your tray, and that is something which is more which is going to actually come in more in contact with the your platforms, your tables and your base, and you never know when it's dirty or wet. And obviously we don't want our project to have very small shelf life, so I am going to use 2-3 coats of varnish on this side. But before that, I need to finish up my inner and the outer side of this tray. So this is how I did this. You can even use some texture on the outside portion to add some extra drama to it. You can make your own DIY texture paste and you can use it and create something amazing for yourself. So I'm done with the outer sides, and at last I'm going to do the brushing work on my borders, and my tray is done. So I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial, and I'm super happy that finally I could do my voiceover. And please do comment below if you actually liked it, and if you have any suggestions, please do mention that. I will be very, very happy to see your comments, and it actually always encourage me to come up with new videos and work for you guys, and sharing few more pictures at the end. Do check that, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.